Okay, so what I have set up here is a couple slip knots, and I want to take my rabbit just on the top side of that joint, pull it nice and tight, and then I'm going to tie it off over here, like so. Again, I want that nice and tight. I'm going to be pulling on the skin. We don't want it to fall off. Another slip knot right here. Again, be above that joint. So there we go. I'm going to, again, tie this off so it stays nice and tight. Alright, so when we do this, we're going to want to pinch the hide to pull it away from the meat, and my blade is always facing up. You don't want to cut the meat, you just want to separate that hide right from it. And so you just keep pinching your way around. Way. And all we're doing is separating it so that we can peel it away from the meat. And you want to be really careful because there's a tendon in there. If you cut that, it'll loosen everything up and really create a problem for us. We don't want to do that. So we pull it down just a little ways, and now we're going to start on this side here. Again, I'm just going to pull that skin away from the meat so that I can work my way around. Working your way around, and don't forget about that tendon. You don't want to hit that. Let's see, figure out where I'm going there. Come back around this way. These are fairly young rabbits, so once we get started on the skin, it's really going to pull away really easy. There. Alright, so the next thing we want to do, is we're going to separate the fur across here. We want to do that so that we can pull both sides down. But we have to be careful because we don't want to hit any areas where urinary tract is, or you can see I can get my fingers right in there and pull it away, but we don't want to hit intestine or anything like that. And you know, there is a little bit of bowel coming out, but we'll take care of that too. And come on this side, we don't go all the way down yet. And again, I'm always keeping my blade away from the meat, so don't want to cut into that meat. And I understand there are quicker ways to remove this hide, but because I am going to actually tan those hides, I don't want to be very careful about what I'm doing. So now, very carefully, I'm going to keep separating here. Like so. Don't want to hit that urinary tract, so I have to be really careful. And I'm using the tip of my knife. I was taught years ago, the tip of your knife is literally an extension of your fingertip. Just want to keep peeling this away here. And get in here like so. Come around on this side. Going to pull her back. Just like this. Very carefully. Same here. Up underneath that skin there, just like so. There we go, separation. Okay, so we still have this area here, tail area. Again, let's just knock this out of our way so we don't try to get that on our meat. Just a little bit of feces there. I'm just going to use something different to paint that with because I don't want to get it on my knife. Working the tip of my knife to separate everything there. So we're now ready to peel down, except what we have to do next is we have to remove the front paws, and you want to look at where you're going here, where they, you can see where they move right there, so just above that joint. And we're just going to snip. It won't cut through the fur, it's just going to break the bone. We're going to do the other side, same thing. You want to feel where that joint is, just above it, and again, snip. Okay, we push those down, we'll grab our knife, and we want to go ahead and cut those right out of there. And this will be so that we can pull that skin right over those. otherwise they're really hard to get past those paws. Alright, the next area we want to deal with is the head. And what I like to do is I'm going to feel and get as close to the head as I can and use my scissors, first of all, to just cut away some of that fur because it's really hard to get our clippers in there. So now I have an area where my clippers can go in. And I'm going to just slide them in there. So, some pressure. Sure got it all. I did. And now I'm just going to go ahead and cut that out. Alright, so now we're ready to peel this right off, just like so. If you have a little trouble here, you can just take and work them out. Can imagine if those paws were still there, what that would be like. All right, so then what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take this and I'm going to roll it up just like so, and I will freeze them so that when I'm ready to go through the tanning process, I'll take them out and thaw them, and we'll talk about that in a different video. All right, so now up a little bit. There we go. We need to open this up very, very carefully, okay? Because we don't want to hit the bladder, intestine, or anything. We want to keep that as clean as possible. So I'm just gonna very carefully use the tip of our knife just to open it up. Okay. We don't want to hit it. I can see it. Show you that bladder. Just a second here. Be really, really careful. Now see how my fingers are in there? I want to do that to separate them from any of the organs inside. Okay. Now you can see the bladder. And it's full. So you want to be really, 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 really careful. Squeeze and pinch that so that none of that can get out. And then go ahead and cut that away and get rid of it quickly. You don't want that to hit the meat. Super important, okay? Alright, so now we've got it opened up. And just carefully let things come out. And if you look, there's some things we're going to be looking for here. Now, to finish this up here, I'm going to cut this. This little ways, and then I'm going to carefully come up and open this up just a little bit, okay? Because what I want to do, try and carefully pull that through. And now, as we open this up, you're going to see this stuff drop out. Drop right into my bucket. Right here is our stomach, and we don't want to puncture that. Get everything out, because the next thing I want you to see is going to be the liver. Separate the liver, our stomach. fasten area. Mm-hmm. Got them separated. And there's something on the liver I want you to see. So this right here, you can see it, is the bile duct. That right there is the bile duct. We do not want to puncture that. Okay, we do not want that to hit our liver. Okay, that's super important. All right, so all I'm going to do is I'm going to cut on both sides of it and just take it out completely. All right, because then I'm going to make liver pate out of this. So I'm just going to take this and cut this here. Here. Move it there. That'll go in my bucket. And the liver, I have a bowl here for that. Alright, next we have our kidneys right here. Kidneys are important because they can also tell the sign of the health. Now I didn't say it, but that liver you want to look at too. You want to look for any spotting on the liver. See spotting, that's a sign of something wrong. A little bit of fat on these guys. They're eating pretty good in there. Wild rabbits, you might not see so much fat on them. These are the kidneys right here. And let's go. Oh, there we go. And then this here, I'm going to show you the liver again, just so you know. Very fresh, no spotting, anything going on there, so we're in good shape. Now, we have to get into this area here. And because these rabbits are so young, my knife will go right through the rib bones, no problem. What separates the organs here and then from the cardiovascular sac, if you will, this whole area, is the diaphragm. I'm just going to open that up. And such a young animal, my knife goes right through that. So, again, I'm just going to use the tip of my knife to open up that diaphragm. And then right there, these are the lungs. Okay. So what I'm going to do is open this up. And we're going to get those lungs out. And attach to those lungs, just like anybody else, is our heart. Hopefully, I can get the esophagus and airway out at the same time, which I did. I'm going to separate that heart from the lungs there. Put that in there as well. Now I just want to double check. Make sure everything's out. It is. Good. And then I'm going to do the same up here. There's a little bit of our intestine in there, so we're just going to push that out. Like so, and very carefully. Again, got it all out of there. If you don't, you want to come up here with your knife, open that up a little bit. Make sure you do. Now, the last thing you want to do is just inspect. Definitely a healthy eater with a little bit of fat on there. Maybe we're too nice to our rabbits, honey. So the next thing we're going to do is we're just going to clip here and clip here. Just a little bit to take it off. And then the rabbit will go into cold water. And we'll let it soak for 48 hours. And that will help remove any of the excess blood or anything that's in the animal. Again, all we're doing is breaking bone. We're not trying to cut through meat. Like that. And just like that. And there we have our skinned and eviscerated rabbit. And I have another video. I'll show you how to break one of these down. But for now, this is where we're at, and I look forward to seeing you guys in the future, and hopefully you'll be working on some rabbits at some point in time.